Chairman. I appreciate it very much. This is for, I think that Dr. Nasser and maybe Mr. Moores also, but earlier this year, Saudi Arabia announced it was changing its mining investment laws. Last week, Papua New Guinea announced it was amending its mining laws. Other countries are considering changes to encourage investment from the mining sector and or reevaluate its production and revenue sharing regimes. Yet here in the United States, we have the General Mining Law of 1872, which frankly is nothing short of an embarrassment to our country. In 1872, Ulysses S. Grant was elected president, and Susan B. Anthony was served an arrest warrant and fined for voting. Tells you how antiquated our laws are for the hard rock mining. If we are serious about reducing our import reliance for critical minerals, our mining laws need to be updated. We need to improve the regulatory scheme for mines in low-risk yet high-grade areas and the claim patent system, and help the mining industry put themselves in a better light in the public by establishing a royalty to share the profits with the American people. So with that, can you please speak to how mining laws impact a country's ability to attract investment and to reduce a mineral dependence? Dr. Nasser.
So as USGS is a scientific organization of the Department of Interior, that's not something that I can really comment about, and I would defer to other federal agencies that would be able to better address that question.
Is there somebody else who wants to speak to that? Nobody.
I can basically from a more Simon Moores here on the screen there. The problem with mining laws and regulation in the US, I can't speak of specific mining laws here, but the point is to attract investment, people look to countries like Canada and Australia as mining friendly jurisdictions. And with the US, it's not known as a mining jurisdiction, especially if you're trying to develop lithium and cobalt and graphite mines. It's just not on the radar. I think a wholesale look at mining laws specific to critical minerals and specific to these raw materials needed in industries that are core to your automotive space or energy storage space should be actually separated out in some way, if that's possible, to help investment in this industry. And I think at the moment, everything is treated as one, and it's not just stifling US mining, but I mean, it's actually detracting a lot of investment.
Thank you. And Dr. Nasser, I think you can answer this one. Last month, you and a handful of other United States Geological Survey scientists published an article in Mining Engineering Magazine discussing the USGS's critical minerals review. You wrote in part, simply establishing domestic mining and concentrate production does nothing to mitigate the risk of downstream processing. It's highly concentrated geographically, imported, and unreliable. Well, I couldn't agree more with you. And we need to make sure we're addressing these gaps. What portion of the supply chain, either upstream or downstream, needs the most attention in terms of our national security?
Thank you, Ranking Member Manchin. So it really, the answer depends on the commodity. So different commodities will have different bottlenecks in their supply chains. In some cases, there's a highly concentrated production on the mining stage. In other cases, it might be further downstream. So for example, for niobium, an element that's produced in only a handful of mines worldwide. And so there are very few mines that are producing it, and a single mine might be producing somewhere on the order of 2/3 of the world's supply. On the other hand, there might be commodities where it's really not about mining, and there's enough concentrate being produced, but we're simply not recovering it further downstream, such as many of the byproducts. So earlier, one of the other witnesses mentioned tellurium. There's a lot of tellurium in some of the concentrate that we're mining with copper. Once it gets to our copper electrolytic refineries, it's simply not recovered for economic reasons. And so there are different stages for different commodities, and that's why I mentioned in my testimony that we do need to look at these supply chains individually to figure out what really is the bottleneck and what strategy would be most effective at reducing that bottleneck.
Well, the U.S. is a net exporter for a handful of minerals. Are there any minerals on that list that we could lose if we do not remain vigilant on that? So what we're exporting now, a few that we do, are we in jeopardy of losing those?
I can't think of off the top of my head what that would look like, but it's something that we can get back to you on.
Please do. Thank you. Thank you, Madam Chair.
Thank you, Senator Manchin.